which are very important to the world of wedding photography, which from my perspective kind of marks it out as a different area from the rest of professional photography, is that if you're working as a professional photographer within an editorial or an advertising environment, whether it's fashion or portraiture, it doesn't really matter, you're trying to build up a client relationship because you're working for a client that's going to you're going to get repeat business from. But of course, with the wedding photography market, once you've shot for your client, the chances are you may get a recommendation, but you're probably only going to shoot for that person once, and that person isn't that experienced, or maybe has no experience in commissioning photography. So the things that are important to a wedding photographer are very different to a lot of the areas of professional photography in that idea of how you market. So is that something that you feel that people are aware of when they either first start their business or as the business starts to grow?
Excuse me. Yeah, when it comes to weddings, I believe the number one thing is your marketing. You can be the best photographer out there, but if you don't know how to market, you're in serious trouble. I have a marketing degree, and that's what's helped me the most. I mean, when I first started my business, put my tennis shoes on, and I contacted every single bridal design shop in Nottingham, all the florists, I mean, who else? Cake makers, the cars, everybody. And I constantly was marketing myself to these people. I would stop in every 2 weeks, introduce myself. Another 2 weeks, I would go back in there, and now they're sick of seeing me. You know, so you have to constantly keep up with these people. Also, Google, you really have to know your SEO. If you go to a computer right now and you put documentary wedding photographers, a UK, you know, wide search, I come up front page. You know, all the Nottingham searches, I'm on the front page. Very important. I'd say I get 50% of my referrals from Google, and most brides will only look at the first page of Google, so you've got to be on the front page of Google. Also, so Google, hitting the streets, and also referrals at weddings. So when I go to weddings, I make friends with the bridesmaids. So I would, like Grant said, I mean, yeah, a lot of it is you'll shoot the wedding and then you won't hear from people, but I'm very lucky that pretty much every wedding I go to, I get 2 or 3 referrals from the wedding. It's all about your people skills, getting along with everybody at the wedding. If you don't have good people skills, probably food or landscape photography is better for you. You know, seriously.
It's an interesting point. We've discussed in the magazine at length about how it's impossible to make a living as a landscape photographer, and I think most landscape photographers would agree on that. But I think that, you know, it does seem to be that the wedding market in particular, and it's something we deal with in Turning Pro magazine, is a lot to do with people who are coming to the wedding photography market, perhaps because they see it as a change of career, but also because they see it as a new business. And I'm always very nervous of promoting that as a quick and easy business in which to make money. Primarily because if you go to Yale.com, you'll see that there are 20,000 wedding photographers on Yale.com. And last year in the UK, there were 200,000 weddings. So it doesn't take a great mathematician to work out that there's a lot of competition, and that only allows someone to do 10 each. Do you think that there is enough understanding of the amount of work involved in becoming a wedding photographer?
Definitely not. I mean, it is such hard work. I mean, all I do is work, work, work. Marketing is so huge. I'm lucky that I have, my father's retired, and he takes care of all the business side of things for me. I mean, and that is a lot of work. So I concentrate more on the marketing and the creative side of things, but people don't realize how much work it is. I mean, I'm constantly working. The marketing is number one, and also, you know, getting yourself out there. You have to, people think, there's a lot of these people we call weekend warriors, and don't get me wrong, if you're a good photographer, that's fine, but it's a full-time business. You know, I shoot the wedding on a Saturday, and it takes me about 3 days after the wedding to do everything else I need to do for that wedding. And a lot of photographers are like, wow, I get £1,000 a wedding. But when you average it out, how much they work, they're making like £5 an hour. So, you know, you've really got to charge what you're worth, you know? I mean, you know, I make decent money and I'm very happy, but I also have other things going on too. I have workshops and seminars and I do some magazine work also. So, you know, to make a living from wedding photography for just shooting weddings, I think is extremely hard, extremely.
Why is it, do you think, that so many, apart from the obviously the arrival of digital cameras, made it a lot more, a lot easier for people to do it? And you know, there's a lot of talk about American photographers shooting thousands of images and that hope of getting one image from those many thousands. But why is it, do you think, that at the moment, as you can see here, I mean, we've had a number of talks over the last couple of days, and this is by far the best attended. Why is it, do you think, that there is that interest at the moment in the idea of being a wedding photographer?
Well, weddings, I mean, how cool are weddings, you know? We go to the most beautiful locations, right? The bride looks, probably she won't look that good ever again in her life, right? You know, the groom looks good, everybody, the wedding looks good, everybody's in a good mood, and, you know, back in the days, what would you do? Create a few images, you know, on a tripod, but now you have free reign to do everything. So at a wedding, I'm doing documentary photography, I'm doing fashion images for the bride, fashion images, group shots, but fun group shots, and you do all this stuff. I even eat really good food, the same as the bride and groom. Can't beat it. So yeah, I just think so many people find that, you know, it's a great form of photography, but they just don't realize how hard it is. I mean, too many people go in there, and I see them all the time. In Nottingham, I see a lot of photographers are up on Google. Months later, they're gone. You know, they're gone. So it's, people just think it's easy money when it's not. I try to tell people that all the time. Don't get into it unless you're willing to work 26 hours a day.
That's pretty kind of a definite kind of a message, but I mean, it's the same kind of message that I would give any photographer who was hoping to make a living from it. But as I was saying before, there does seem to be a very different approach to the wedding market than there is to other areas of photography. But at the same time, as you're saying, you're talking about shooting fashion images of people at the wedding. You know, there's portraiture involved, there's reportage involved, there's still life involved. So actually an awareness of all of those areas and what's contemporary.